In this GIMP workshop, we are going to create a semi-exploded view. If you want to follow along, you can find the download link for the image in the video description. When we've opened GIMP, we right-click on the layer and click Add Alpha Channel. We'll start by making a selection of the rear mudguard and the rear wheel. Press the B key to activate the Paths tool. When we hold the Control key and roll the mouse wheel, we can zoom in or out. Zoom in to the back of the car. Now we can place notes, as shown in the video, to select the outline of the mudguard. We will add curves in a minute. When we press and hold the spacebar, the cursor changes into the navigation cross, and we can, by moving the mouse without clicking, move the image. With Ctrl+Z, we can undo one or more previous steps, and with Ctrl+Y, we can redo them. In this way, we can make our selection around the mudguard. When we are close to the starting point, we place the cursor on the first node, press and hold the Control key, and when we see the chain icon, we click to close the path. We can still move nodes if necessary. Then we go down to the exhaust pipe to select the two areas that we want to remove, and again we use the Control key to close these paths. Now we go to the tool options and check the option Edit. Then we can, by click and drag, place new nodes and make curves. We can move the handles to make corrections, but we cannot move the node itself. We can, however, delete it with Ctrl+Z and try again. In this way, we can follow the path and click and drag nodes to make curves. Zoom out a little to show the whole mudguard, including the wheel. In the tool options, we press the button Selection from Path. We will select the wheel with the Ellipse Select tool. Press the E key to make the Ellipse Select tool active. The path is now invisible. At the mode in the tool options, we click the second option, which is Add to Current Selection. Check Fixed Aspect Ratio, which should be default 1:1. Then we drag out the circle shape around the wheel. With the handles and the corners, we can make corrections, and by click and drag inside the selection, we can move the whole selection. Then click in one of the corners to apply. Now the mudguard and the wheel are one selection. Press Ctrl X to cut the selection, and press Ctrl V to paste it again. Now we click on the new layer icon at the bottom of the layers panel to change the floating layer into an actual layer. We make this layer invisible by clicking the eye. Select the car layer again. We move with the scroll bar the image so we can see the front wheel. Click and drag a circle to make a selection of the front wheel and make corrections if necessary. Then click in one of the corners to apply. Press Ctrl X to cut, and then Ctrl V to paste. Click on the new layer icon and make the layer invisible. Select the car layer again and press Ctrl Shift J to maximize it in the window. From now on, we will make our selection with the Paths tool, so press the B key to make it active again. Select the option Design. Zoom into the front door. Now we can place notes, just as we did with the rear mudguard, around the outline of the door. Make sure to include the mirror and the black of the door rubbers. When we are close to the starting point, we place the cursor on the first node, press and hold the Ctrl key, and when we see the chain icon, we click to close the path. In the same way, we select the upper and the lower part of the window. Now we go to the tool options and check the option Edit. Then we click and drag new nodes where we need to make curves. When this is done, we click on the button Selection from Path. Press Ctrl X to cut the selection and press Ctrl V to paste it. Click on the new layer icon at the bottom of the layers panel to change the floating layer into an actual layer. We make this layer also invisible by clicking the eye. Select the car layer again and press Ctrl Shift J to maximize it in the window. Now press the M key or any other tool to make the path invisible, and then we press the B key to make the path tool active again. Select the option Design. In this way, we can continue selecting all the different car parts, such as the front mudguard, where we include the bumper and some black of the shadow, the hood and the headlight, the back door, the roof without the front part, and the bottom with the door style. In the areas where there is transparency, we don't need to follow the outline exactly, but we can select roughly around our subject. For the sake of the tutorial, we will go a bit fast forward now. When we have all our separate car parts, we can make a proper composition. Press Ctrl Shift J to maximize the image in the window. Press and hold the Shift key and click on the eye of the car layer so all the layers become visible. Let go of the Shift key and click again on the eye so the car layer is invisible. Then click the new layer icon at the bottom of the layers panel. Name it Background. Change the width to 2120 and the height to 1193. We change the layer fill type to white and click OK. Then we click on the duplicate icon to make a duplicate of this layer. Press the M key to activate the Move tool. When we use the option Pick a layer or guide, we have to make sure to click inside the subject of the layer to move it, and not in the transparent area. Then we can click and drag the separate car parts to their proper place, as shown in the video. When you're sure that everything is in its place, we make the two background layers invisible by clicking their eyes. Then right-click on one of the other layers and hit Merge Visible Layers. Here we just click Merge. Click both background layers visible again. Now we go to the menu bar, click Filters, Light and Shadow, and Drop Shadow. Here we make the X as well as the Y offset 12 and the opacity 50 by clicking one time on the slider line. then hit OK. Select the top background layer. Then press the L key to activate the Blend tool. I've chosen the gradient Tropical Colors. And change the shape to conical symmetric. Now we click and draw a line from the center of the front car door outwards. This we can do again and again until the result is to our liking. Reduce the opacity to 80 or to whatever looks good for you, and there it is, our own handmade exploded view. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if that's the case, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and leave a nice comment to support my channel. Thank you very much for watching.